Mr. Simons, ladies and gentlemen, the Global Landscapes Forum is one of the most important platforms for sustainable landscape management. It gives scientists, practitioners, municipalities, and political decision makers a chance to exchange ideas, build networks, and learn from each other across disciplines. This year's forum focuses on one of the most important questions for the future of humankind. How can we end hunger while protecting the biological wealth of our planet? Current conditions are making it even harder to meet this challenge. In spite of development achievements, more than 820 million people still suffered from hunger last year. In East Africa, the worst locust plague in decades is destroying the livelihoods of millions of small farmers. A climate change is making the situation even worse. Now, in addition to all this, the COVID-19 pandemic is hitting the world. In many countries, it is not only causing a health crisis, but also an economic and food crisis. An additional 130 million people are threatened by hunger now. 500 million people might be thrown into extreme poverty. In Africa, half of the jobs are risked due to the pandemic, including many in agriculture. All this has disastrous consequences for local and regional food security. The COVID-19 crisis may undo the development progress of the last few decades. We must not let that happen. My ministry is therefore preparing an emergency COVID-19 support program for 1 billion euros. 1 in 5 euros from that package will go forward to food security, for example, forward supporting the work of the World Food Programme and the Global Agricultural and Food Security Programme. In our activities are designed to address both the consequences of the COVID-19 crisis and the consequences of climate change. Sustainable food security means that we need to consider the health of humans, animals, and the natural environment in a holistic way. The transmission of the new coronavirus from animals to humans shows the dangers posed by the rapid loss of ecosystems. We can prevent this through sustainable agriculture and land use, and we need to restore degraded landscapes. Our COVID-19 package will therefore strengthen One Health approach with focuses on human, animal, and environmental health. In order to better understand the complex interdependencies and develop sustainable solutions, we need effective research. So we welcome the reform process of the Consultative Group of International Agriculture Research, and we are glad about the merger of the Center for International Forestry Research and the World Agroforestry Center. We wish them continued success. Ladies and gentlemen, the current pandemic shows the great importance of good governance and joint action. At present, policymakers, scientists, and civil society are working very closely together everywhere. Now, we also need joint action in the effort of create a world without hunger to save our planet. I'm convinced that we can succeed. In every crisis, there is opportunity.